So today's video is all about a question I actually get a lot. Like if I went through my DMs and all my messages, it would probably be top two, and I'm pretty sure it wouldn't be number two. And that question is, how do you find Spotify playlists?
It's the network.
Now, I'm pretty sure that the people that are asking me this question are probably just getting into marketing. Somehow they ended up on the road of Spotify playlisting. Maybe you got finessed by a playlist curator that told you he could get you on Rap Caviar for $50. Maybe you paid a guy $1,000 just to get you on two playlists that had like 10,000 followers. But because you guys were so nice about it, and because y'all were so persistent in asking me this question, I'm going to give you my playlisting strategy that I use to find playlists for my clients, our own network, and even sometimes I use it to help my artist friends when they're trying to do the same thing. Now, with that being said, before we get into today's video, come and follow me on TikTok and Instagram. Links will be in the description below. Come give me some video ideas, tap in, say what's up. I'm trying to make these videos a little bit more tailored to you and your problems, so it would help if you could hit me with some video ideas from time to time. If not, it's cool. I'll figure it out, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, enough of you guys ask me questions. Now, the first strategy that I like to use is something that I like to call the about section strategy. Now, for this strategy, you'll either need to already know about a playlist that takes submissions, know an artist that is currently getting themselves playlisted, or have the bandwidth to go through Spotify and do a bunch of keyword searching. So let's assume that you're on the former end, right? Let's assume that you don't know any playlists, you don't know anybody that's on playlists, you're doing this at ground zero. So what you'll want to do is go to Spotify from your desktop, search a keyword that is related to the genre of playlist you're looking for. So if you're a rapper, search rap or hip hop or something like that. Once you search this keyword, you want to make sure that you filtered out your searches by playlist. So not songs, not albums, only playlists on Spotify. And once you've done this, you want to scroll through all of the playlists that they have listed until you find a playlist that is ran by an independent curator. And the way that you'll know that it's ran by an independent curator is because where it has the name at, it won't say Spotify, it won't say Filter, it won't say Toxify, and it won't say Dixter. It'll say something else. Stay away from those four brands, those four companies. You won't get on those playlists. Now, once you found a playlist that is independently curated, you see that they're being ran by some type of brand or curator or independent curator or something like that, scroll through the playlist until you find an artist that you've personally never heard of. Preferably, you want this artist to have around 50,000 monthly listeners or less. Sometimes you can go over that, but I've just learned from personal experience that it's a lot easier to do this method if you can keep the artist that you're using at around 50,000 monthly listeners or less. Once you found this artist that you personally never heard of that has 50,000 or less monthly listeners, you're going to click on their artist, go to their profile, and then click on about on their Spotify profile. Now, if you look at this about section for them, you will see that it lists the top five playlists that artist is currently on. And the reason that you're doing this is because this artist is either someone that has figured out the sauce on getting on playlists, or they've hired someone that has the sauce on getting them on the playlist. Either way, you've cheat coded yourself to the top of the pile by just going to the playlist that they have and they're already on. And you know these playlists are taking artist submissions because this artist is on it. So once you find the information, once you find these playlists, you'll just need to click through the playlist, see if they have some type of contact information, reach out to their playlist, get their prices, get their rules for pitching and all that stuff, and then rinse and repeat the process. You now have a new list of playlists that you know take artist submissions. Go through those playlists, find more artists that you've never heard of, go to their about section, find more playlists, rinse, repeat, rinse, repeat, rinse, repeat. The second way that I like to find playlists is by using a tool called Chartmetric. Now, Chartmetric is this really dope data analytics tool that's used by A&Rs and marketing agencies within the music industry. Really cool stuff. Now, once you get the Chartmetric, you'll need to search artists that are within your niche. So if you're a rapper that makes, I don't know, trap rap, search artists like 21 Savage, Moneybagg Yo, something like that. If you're an R&B artist, search artists like Mariba and Baby Rose, or just search artists that are within your niche and within your demographic. Now, once you search these artists and go into their profile, if you scroll to the bottom of their Chartmetric profile, you will see they have a section where you can see all of the playlists that an artist is currently on or has been on in the past. Now, if you have the paid version, you can see as far back as, I believe, an entire year. I think with the free version, you can only see the last 30 days or so. But that's cool because that's enough of a window for you to be able to find some playlists to get yourself pitched on. Now, this method is really useful for finding playlists that are placing artists that are very similar to you. And if you know anything about the Spotify algorithm and how it works, getting on playlists that make sense for your niche rather than getting on ones that just brings you a lot of streams will significantly benefit your account long term and just placing yourself on some random playlist that'll get you 20,000 streams or so. So because you can find these playlists that these artists are currently on or have been on, you are actively being able to place yourself around artists and within the niche that makes sense for you in the Spotify algorithm, which once again will just significantly increase your chances of hitting the algorithm and all these positive things happening, which should be the goal of getting yourself placed on playlists in the first place. From there, it's very similar to the about section strategy, where if you have ever seen a playlist profile on Chartmetric, they usually will have the contact information listed on there. If not, you can always click into their Spotify playlist link and go to their description section on Spotify and see if they have like a Twitter handle or Instagram handle or email or something. Now, another cool thing about Chartmetric's playlist feature is that you can filter it out based on editorial playlists and then non-editorial playlists, or pretty much user-generated playlists, which makes the search process for this so much easier, especially when you're trying to make sure you're getting on playlists that are demographically relevant to you, which once again, I suggest that you all are trying to get on playlists they're demographically relevant to you. The third tool that I like to use to find Spotify playlists is a fairly new tool called Playlist Supply. It is a data scraping tool for Spotify. And you can type in any keyword, right? Rap, hip hop, R&B, Selena Gomez, whatever type of playlist you're trying to find. As you're getting ready to queue up your search for Playlist Supply, it will also give you the option to filter out playlists based on ones that have a Twitter handle in the description, an email in the description, an Instagram handle in the description, or nothing whatsoever if you just want everything to show up. Meaning that if you're trying to find rap playlists that are easy to communicate with and get in contact with, you can just search rap, playlists that have an email, hit search, and then Playlist Supply will scrape through all of Spotify and find all of the playlists that match your search criteria. So in this example, it'll go through and find all the playlists that have rap in their username or their description name and have an email address in their bio. Now, this tool saves you so much time. I think it's one of the most useful things I've come across in the last 2-3 months or so. It's only like $20 a month, so it's pretty cheap, and it saves you a shit ton of time. Using the About section strategy and the Chartmetric strategy, it will honestly take me anywhere from an hour to 2 or 3 hours to find playlists, depending on just how things were moving for me that night. But with Playlist Supply, I can just type in these criteria, hit search, and it takes about 15 to 20 minutes to find these playlists, and I can go do other stuff while scraping through these playlists for me. So once again, it's a huge game changer in the time space, and it does so much work for you that you were going to manually have to do anyway. Now, if you want to do the manual labor and you want to just sharpen your skills through doing that, then once again, the About section strategy and the Chartmetric strategy are going to be your best ways to find playlists. But if you have $20 extra a month and you want to save some time by building out a massive playlist list pretty quick, then check out Playlist Supply. I'll put their link in the description below as well so you can check them out. And there we have it. Those are pretty much my 3 go-to methods for finding Spotify playlists. So you have your About section strategy, you have Chartmetric, and then you have Playlist Supply. And once again, if you use these methods and you're willing to put the time in to find your own playlist, you will never need to use another playlist curator or playlist pitching service ever again. Because I promise you that the higher up you get into playlist pitching, the more you do it, you'll really start to find all the playlists that these guys are using anyway. The playlisting world is only so big, you know? And you'll even be able to stay on top of newer playlists even faster than some of those guys are, because most playlist pitchers just stick to their same network of playlists that they trust. So you'll be able to find these new playlists and these other playlists maybe even before they get to it. And, you know, once again, save yourself time, money, energy, and the risk of being finessed by a pitcher who's telling you they can get you on Rap Caviar for $50. True story, by the way. I've seen that. Other than that, if you feel like you learned anything today, please like and share this video. Hit those post notifications as well, as it really helps the channel out. Other than that, once again, my name is Corey, and I'll see y'all next time. Peace.